Here we are at Wroxham. You're watching Adventure Fords, and today we'll be going on a little boat ride, won't we?
Yeah, we will. Yeah, we'll be going on the Broads today.
Yeah, that'll be with Wroxham Launch Hire. So we'll take a look on the boat and see what's going on at the river. We'll be heading towards Hoveden area and see how far we get. Possibly go up to the lakes as well, won't we? Yeah. Yeah, so enjoy a nice little boat trip with us, and we'll take you for a little ride around, see the nice houses and wildlife that's in the area as well. Enjoy. It's a little bit muddy down here, isn't it?
It is today, yeah. A bit muddy. A lot of rain and fuel over the past couple of days. A lot of roads have been flooded and things, so not a surprise, but it should still be a good day.
Yeah, and you can tell that the water level's really high as well. So it's actually lowered down a little bit more now, hasn't it?
Yes, it has, definitely. But should be a good day. It's sun's out at the moment, and I think it's only meant to rain again, I think, from about 2 o'clock onwards. So fingers crossed it won't rain while we're on the boat, but if it does, we'll show you that experience.
Yeah, so it's a little bit deeper here as well, isn't it?
Yep.
Just over here is where we'll be going on the little boat ride. Yeah, so let's take a little ride on the boat down the river. Yeah, and check out our previous vlog here from Wroxham back in the autumn time.
What swans are they in if you're looking for them?
How long are we going to do?
2 hours. I did.
2 hours.
Yeah, I think cool. Yes, yeah.
What I need is, put your name and address and a mobile number on there.
Yeah.
Yeah, so here we are, we're on the boat, on the Broads,
yeah,
aren't we?
We are indeed, yeah.
So yeah, we'll take a little adventure out.
See how we get on.
That's it. Yeah, some lovely houses here as well. See, we've got some swans. Yeah, we've got a diesel engine, haven't we? So it's quite nice and noisy.
Yes, it is.
We did have the option of the electric boat, didn't we?
Yeah, but that one isn't as well covered as this one, is it? So
no.
We've got the diesel today. So hopefully this one will be about in its way. And we'll go around the Broads. We have been told to keep to the middle today, so if anyone's been on the Broads, you probably know you're usually told to keep to the right.
Yeah, it's just
quite
water. Water, isn't it? Yeah.
You've been told to keep to the middle.
Yeah, keep to the middle.
To the right if other boats are coming towards us. So, hence why we're sort of in the middle, as you can see.
Yeah. Yeah, that'll be your turn, see?
Yeah, I'll take over in a moment. So,
there we go.
Let's go.
Carry on, down a minute.
Yeah.
lovely houses. We've got a house with thatched roofs as well. Yeah, really nice properties. Lovely to own. A lot of them have their own boat ports as well. Yeah, some are rented out as well as B&Bs possibly. A lot of maintenance as well on the river, such as reeds have been sort of cut back a little bit of deadwood, and we've had a lot of winter storms as well, which has caused a little bit of disruption in the river. As you can see, some fallen trees as well. So there's a lot of cut back for the wildlife and obviously to keep the river accessible for all large boats. Yeah, so some lovely views of the river here. And here we've got the Wroxham Broad, which, yeah, it's very windy today, so not many boats out on the lake. It's quite an expansive sort of size of the river, part of the river and the broad. It's quite an open area as well. Through there's a good stopping area. Zoom up. Yeah, there's not many boats on the river today. So, yeah, very high river levels. There's quite a current in the water as well, and it is a little bit windy. Yeah, it's quite cool as well, it's about 5 degrees. Hopefully it'll warm up a little bit later on. Where the Wroxham launch pier is, just about here. Yeah, and we're heading down towards Crofton Great Broad. We're just now past the Wroxham Broad, heading up our way to Houghton, and then possibly through to Hornet. See how far we get, but we'll see what the time is doing. Yeah, because we've only got 2 hours.
Yes, we've booked this for 2 hours at a price of £50, which I think is really reasonable.
Yeah, £50, which is really good. Yeah, for 2 hours. Yeah, back at the map again. Yeah, and the river speed is around about 4 miles per hour.
There's places you can do 5 miles, however, with the current conditions, probably best to stick at 4 if you come on the roads. Like we have all this load of flooding and things in the ports.
That's it.
Obviously, each boat hire will tell you what they expect and will give you advice about whether you should go on the rocks and broad, like today we were told not to, just because of the conditions. But other days you can go on there, can't you?
That's correct, yes. Normally we would do if the tide is a little low as well, and also isn't as windy and there isn't as much of the current.
I'd always say, if you get any advice from the guys who hire the boats out to you, follow it. You know, that's the way you're going to get yourself the least amount of trouble when you're driving the boat, and you're less likely to get any issues when you're on the boards with other boaters who use them regularly more than if you just hire them on a day boat. So I'd always follow the advice of the guys who you hire your day boats from.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. It's always good to follow the guidance and the rules as well. Yeah, so just through the bushes there, you can see the Norfolk Broads Yacht Club. Yeah, try and zoom in. Got some geese there as well. It's quite unique to see it so empty as well. Wroxham Broads. Yeah, and again you can just see Norfolk Broads Yacht Club. Steering wheel, and also we've got the forward and back lever down here. Yeah. There we go.
And the guy said to us that 20 on here means 4 miles per hour, so that's the speed that we've been asked to keep at today, so that's the speed we're going to do. You know, if you are wondering what the other speeds are, do feel free to ask the guys who you hire your boats from. I'm sure they'll be able to give you the information.
Quite basic controls, quite good to use for anything, for anybody really, aren't they? Or accessibility.
Yes, more people to do it.
Yeah.
And you can see that's Richardson's day boat there that they used.
Yeah.
There's many different.
That's Richardson's boats, yeah. There's many day boat companies there, isn't there?
There's plenty around the course. I mean, we have used Wroxham Launch Hire today. They're not sponsors. They're not, you know, asked us to do this. We're just filming it because we wanted to come on the boards and we've used them before and we've liked their service. Again, feel free to use who you're most comfortable with and you want to, you know. There's many different companies in Wroxham you can use. So do use them. And here we have the two little swans, so try and hopefully avoid them.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, just it'll be a nice day to come on the boards, don't it?
Yeah, it's lovely. It's growing up, which is nice.
Yeah, definitely.
As I say, in terms of being used for your launch hire and your boat hire, use anyone you feel happy with, you know. There are boat hire companies outside of Wroxham that offer, I think there's some from, is there any from Stalham in that way, I think?
There's several up towards Horning, isn't there?
Yeah.
That sort of area.
Yeah, so do use who you feel you want to. Speak to friends and family if they've been on the cruise before for recommendations. You know, do your own research. As we say, we've used Wroxham Launch Hire today, but you can use whoever you feel most comfortable with.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, there's plenty to choose from. And even don't have the day boat as well, it's quite good. Yeah, like they call them like picnic boats, don't they?
Yeah, you can get picnic boats.
And even a river tour on the wherry, I think it's called.
Yeah.
And little boats like that. Yeah, big guide tour.
Yeah.
Guided tours.
You've got like the Broad Hire, which I think also does some of the tour boats as well. So, you know, always have a look. Have a look when you come to the Broads. Definitely, if you're going to come to Norfolk and you like boating and you don't get, you know, sort of sickness or on a boat, that definitely hire one out or at least go on a tour.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we'll carry on up the river. See what else there is to see here on the Norfolk Broads 2024. Yeah, some good places to stop the boat. Plenty of places to moor up along the river as well. There are several spaces to moor up towards the Bournemouth area. Yeah, so we're currently entering the South House Broad area. Again, there's plenty of places to moor up. You can get out for a walk as well. Yeah, it's a lovely area. Yeah, not too busy today. Just through there is Crofton Great Broad. It's probably as big as the Wroxham Broad. Lovely little hidden little properties as well alongside. Yeah, look like it's an old little windmill there. Or a mill. Yeah, very nice.
see. There's some residential homes and also holiday chalets as well. Yeah, we're just coming up to Horning here on the Norfolk Broads.
Yeah, some really lovely properties, isn't there? Very nice on the summer's evening as well, just sitting outside by the river, taking the views in. Yeah, so we've been travelling up the river now for nearly 50 minutes now, so we'll be turning round very soon and heading back towards Wroxham. I believe the weather's changing a little bit as well. It's like it's going to start raining again soon. Yeah, so in the distance is Horning. Horning Sailing Club. Yeah, so we're now going to turn around and head back. Yeah, this is a lovely area, Horning. Plenty of couple of pubs as well, such as we've got the Swan Inn, and further down the river we've got the Ferry Inn. Got the Southern Comfort. I believe you can hire that out for events, I think even weddings as well. And here's the Horning Sailing Club. So we're going to make our way back down to Wroxham and see what views we've got on the way down. Yeah, it really is some nice properties here. Very nice, it's got the balconies around the property. And you've got the marina as well. Yeah, lovely gardens as well. And even some geese and a duck.
have made our way back to Wroxham though. Yeah, so we're just currently coming up to Wroxham Bridge, just as we are over the harbour at the moment. A few swans coming into land as well. Nice boats here as well. Got electric hybrid vehicles as well, or hybrid boats rather. Hotel Wroxham there. Got plenty of swans as well. Yeah, so we just got off the boat here. Yeah, you're now feeding the swans, aren't you?
Yeah, we are.
Did you enjoy your boat ride?
I did indeed, it was a really good thing, didn't you? Feed some of the pigeons, feed some of the swans. Hazel. Just got a couple, a lot of them are down the other end, aren't they, today? But I thought we'll feed these ones, so we'll go down here.
That's it, yeah. Yeah, it's good to donate a little bit, isn't it, as well?
Yeah, this bag help costs, out. £1.
Yeah, £1. There we go. Even got the pigeons involved as well, haven't we? There we go. I think last time we came down here, we had a whole swarm of swans, geese, didn't we?
We did indeed, yeah. There's probably different kinds of geese down the front here at Wroxham. You can get them sort of there. From here, over by like the old mill sometimes do some, and over the other side as well, so...
Attracting the geese now as well.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we've got geese across the water there. I think they're keeping an eye out as well.
We are almost done now.
Yeah, right then, we'll finish feeding these and then we'll wrap up today's vlog here at Wroxham. Yeah, so that concludes our day here at Wroxham on the Broads 2024. Yeah, that's a great little trip out, wasn't it?
It was, yeah, really lovely. Great to get back on the boat, great to go along the Broads again. And yeah, even though it was short, it was a lovely short but sweet ride, and it was just perfect for a day like today, wasn't it?
Yeah, we spent about 2 hours, didn't we? So we travelled an hour up to Hornin, and then from Horn and back down here to Wroxham. So yeah, it's a good couple of hours.
Yeah.
Time goes very quick, and a lot to see as well. You do get the option of maybe 2 to 4 hours, don't you?
Yeah, and half day.
A day boat as well, yeah.
So yeah, pick whichever one you like. Obviously go with the company you like. Obviously, as you know, today we were with Wroxham Launch Hire. That's just who we've used in the past and who we find to be sort of the best for us and what we like to do on board. But again, there's many different options from many different boats out there, so always pick and have a look into ones for yourself.
Yeah, the staff are very friendly, very helpful as well with Wroxham Launch Hire. But yeah, great to come back here and to see what's going on the roads, and we'll be back hopefully here in the summertime,
yes,
when the weather will be a bit better and a bit more sunnier, and maybe the water won't be so high.
Definitely, I mean, it will be a different experience with it being in the summertime. It'll be a lot busier on the broads, as they tend to be, but it'll be good as well to sort of show you. Maybe we'll go a little bit further, maybe we'll go a different route as well.
Yeah, definitely, yeah, we'll definitely be coming back hopefully. Maybe on a different boat, perhaps.
Yes,
you never know.
Yeah. You never know.
Yeah, so that leaves with our final words for today, as keep being active.
Keep being active, everyone. Bye.
Bye, thanks for watching.